Please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance.
Please push in your chair.
Salute. Put your right hand over your heart.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, to the republic which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, for liberty and justice for all. Please join me for a moment of silence.
Tigers, I wanted to give you some information about our fresh fruits and vegetable grant that we received at Tyson this year. It allows our kindergarten through fifth grade students to get a free fruit or vegetable snack twice per week. For example, these delicious strawberries. Our snack days are Tuesday and Friday. This helps introduce healthy food choices. Also, you can find out more information about our fresh fruits and vegetable program on the Fresh Fruits and Vegetable fact sheet and schedule in the parent newsletter. Have a great day.
Hi, this is Dan. Let's talk about the Constitution. You and I live in the United States. There are 50 states within the United States. Each state has a government with a set of rules. You know, we all have rules to follow. I bet your mom and dad has rules for you to follow in your house, right? You probably gotta clean your room, wash your dishes. Oops, don't drop the plate. When I was a kid, I used to cut the grass, and then in the fall, I had to rake the leaves. That was fun. I'd rake them in a big pile, then jump in the pile. Did you ever do that? That's a lot of fun. Imagine if we didn't clean up after ourselves. Our house would be a mess, wouldn't it? Grass would grow way too long, leaves would be everywhere, and our rooms and our kitchens would be very dirty. That means life without rules would be really messy. You can't even play sports without rules, can you? Hey, no cheating over there! Now, some people live in the state of California, some in Illinois, some in Texas. Yeah, that's where they got all the cattle. And I love the big hats. Every state in the union has a set of rules. What state do you live in? Your state has rules too. You can find those rules in your state's constitution. Now, a constitution is a document that describes how your government is organized and how the people in government create rules to keep our states from getting messy. Now, the 50 states are part of one big union. And as a union, the states have relationships with each other. That means we need a government to make sure the union doesn't get messy. Just as each state has its own government, there's one government that governs all 50 states. The United States Constitution is the law of this union. Here's how it starts. We, the people of the United States, in order to form a more perfect union, establish justice, ensure domestic tranquility, provide for the common defense, promote the general welfare, and secure the blessings of liberty to ourselves and our posterity, do ordain and establish this Constitution for the United States of America. Now, I know there were a lot of big words in that, but did you know that you were mentioned in those words? That's right, you were mentioned. Where? In the word posterity. Posterity means children. The Constitution was written so that children, like you, can enjoy the happiness that comes with freedom. You know, we can't have freedom without rules, and the Constitution is the law of the land. It's the rule that governs our great union. The Constitution is a fun document. Read it, know it, and share it with others. This is Dan. I'll talk to you next time. Until then, be good.
Stand up, push in your chair, and get ready to move.
Be the safe tiger. Just do the motions. Please sit down.
Good morning, Tigers. This week, your teachers have been talking to you about the learner quality determined. To be determined means that we do not give up when we're faced with a challenge. This morning, we're going to hear from three friends from Ms. Jones's class who are going to tell us about times that they were determined, times that they did not give up and they learned something new.
Sophia Perez. One time I was determined to work a math problem. I kept trying and trying. I asked my sister for help. Now I can do subtraction.
My emphasis is lower. One time I was determined to shoot basketball. I practiced one day. I was shooting for 4 hours. I didn't give up. Now I can shoot basketball.
Hi, my name's Emily. One time I was determined to ride a bike. I kept trying. I told my sister to help me. I put one foot on the road and one foot on the pedal. Now I can ride a bike.
When you wanna do something that's new and it seems really, really hard to do, you feel like quitting, you feel you're through. Well, I have some advice for you. Don't give up. Keep on trying, you're gonna make it. I ain't lying, don't give up. Don't ever quit. Try and try, and you can do it. Don't give up, yeah. If you want to catch a ball, but you're having no luck at all, the ball hits your head, it hits your nose, it hits your belly, your chin, and toes. Well, try and try and try again. Keep on trying, and soon then you'll put your hands out in the air. You'll catch that ball, yes, this I swear. Don't give up, keep on going. You're on a boat, so keep on rolling. Don't give up, don't ever stop. Try and try, and you'll come out on top. Don't give up. You skip and dip and slip and flip. Well, try and try and try some more, and soon you're skating across the floor. Don't give up, keep on moving. You're gonna get there, just keep on grooving. Don't give up, don't pack it in. Try and try and you will win. Don't give up, no, 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 don't give up. No, 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 don't give up.
Looking regular kid. But you're a hero. Whether you're a kid or a grown-up, you're way more than you might think you are.
You're more than your problems and you're more than your mistakes.
Somewhere inside, you're a hero.
You might not have a cape or wear underwear outside your clothes.
That's probably a good thing. You have everything right now to change the world. Everything! Heroes are just ordinary people who've done extraordinary things.
They inspire other people to be extraordinary.
People like Nathaniel.
He's 12 years old and he's now okay with the fact that there are people in the world who don't have clean water. He raised enough money to help 30 schools in Central Africa.
Madison, when she was 15, she created a beauty pageant for boys and girls that have special needs because she wanted to celebrate real beauty. My friend Bob, he's 55 and he's living out love in so many different ways. Right now, he's working on building the school so kids in Uganda know they're loved.
Kids can change the world, and grown-ups can change the world. It would go a whole lot faster if we worked together. Heroes are made when ordinary people like you and me
decide to be extraordinary. Or extra, extra ordinary.
Extra, extra, extra.
Extra, 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 extra ordinary.
That's too many extras.
Here's what I'm trying to say.
If you want to be awesome, treat people awesome. It's about strength. Firepower!
Not like picking up a car kind of strength.
I'll pick it up and just drop it and go like, oh, he's so nerdy but so strong. I want to go out with him. He can pick up a car. But it's not about that. I'm talking talking about compassion.
Nothing stronger than that.
It's what changes things.
So who's been a hero to you?
Da-da-da!
Parents?
Teachers?
Friends? Let them know. Heroes don't always know that you're heroes.
We all need reminders.
The little things that we do are a big deal.
Heroes are people in our lives who see us what we really are.
Awesome.
Did you hear that?
I said it. You're awesome!
You're awesome.
You don't need a cape and you don't need money. You don't even need to be bitten by something radioactive.
You just need to care. And if you are bitten by something radioactive, you should go to a doctor, sir. It'll make you pee green.
It would be cool to fly or be part spider or be part squirrel.
I don't think part squirrel is a thing. Is that a thing? Like a man squirrel?
But you're already filled with superpowers.
So don't wait for a signal in the sky. Look a little closer at the world around you.
You're ready right now. It's time to be the hero that you're meant to be, Cape. What are you not okay with?
Think about it.
Now what do you have?
And who can you bring with you? Everybody!
Everybody! Everybody! You have everything that you need to make someone's day more awesome.
Someone may never have told you this,
but I promise it's true.
The world needs heroes, and that hero could be you.
That hero could be you. And that hero could be you! Let's do this!
Where does a pencil go for vacation?
To Pennsylvania.
What lies in the kindergarten classroom at nighttime?
The alphabet.
Which month has 28 days?
All of them!
What did the watermelon say to the pineapple? What's up?
Girls, we are about to do our Tyson Tiger song, so I just wanted to let you know how we're going to do it this year in order to stay safe. So for right now, the rules are that we're not able to sing unless we can space really far apart, at least 6 feet, and so since it's hard to do that in our classrooms, we are not going to sing. Instead, we're going to just sing it in our heads. And we're going to do the motions, we're going to keep the steady beat. Now when it comes to the part where, you know, we can learn and reach and grow, we're going to do all those motions. At the end, we're going to do the T-Y-S-O-N. So you can do all the motions for that, but just sing it in your heads and participate with us with keeping a steady beat. So we hope you enjoy. This is a video of us doing the Tyson Tiger song, and here we go.